Hi, my name is Laís Bodanzky. I'm a director of Just Like Our Parents, a Brazilian film. This is our premiere and in my first time in Berlinale.
And my name is Maria Ribeiro. I am I'm an actress, and I am Rosa in Como Nossos Pais, about a film about the women nowadays doing so much things, and our mothers and our daughters, and how do we do so many things, trying to change some things.
Chama o super beijo na mão. A mãe do guaxinim pegou a mão esquerda dele, abriu a mão assim bem forte, fez um carinho e deu um beijo bem na palma da mão do filho.
Eu achei essa história muito infantil. Por que você escolheu essa história?
Porque a sua irmã gosta, meu amor. Amanhã eu leio outra pra você, tá bom?
Você tá chorando, mãe?
Boa noite, meu beijo de boa noite.
Você tá saindo?
Quero meu beijo de boa noite. Vem aqui, agora, dona Mara. Qual que é o beijo mais gostoso?
Jantar na casa de quem?
Do Bruno. É uma reunião. Vários sociólogos, antropólogos, colegas. A gente vai discutir o...
Antropólogas.
Código florestal, impacto nas tribos. Você precisa que eu fique? Se você quiser, posso ficar.
Imagina. Quem sou eu pra atrapalhar? Você precisa salvar o planeta.
Tchau, beijo.
Onde é que você leu essa matéria? Rosa. Uma revista minha, né? Provavelmente. É. Você não entendeu o que dizia o artigo.
O que eu não entendi?
Como eles cuidam das crianças, né? No dia a dia.
Você podia aprender um pouquinho com essa tribo, né? Coisa do dia a dia.
Não acredito que você tá pedindo pro seu marido abandonar tudo que ele faz pra dar banho nas suas filhas. Mais importante do que preservar a reserva Yanomami, a floresta amazônica, enfrentar as mineradoras poderosas, é escrever um texto para um site de banheiro com o objetivo de obrigar as pessoas a clicarem curtir. Minha filha, você prefere que o teu marido fique na sua casa dando banho nas suas filhas? Um menino com um projeto, um trabalho ambientalista desse? Que egoísmo, Rosa. Fica esperta.
Welcome to the Berlinale. I watched your film yesterday. Very close to my heart. It's nice to see three women here, and the film screams women and feminism. My first question is, where did the idea come from, first of all, to make this particular film?
Essa ideia surgiu há 4 anos atrás, um desejo meu pessoal de retratar a minha própria geração dessa mulher contemporânea, com esses vários papéis que ela não dá conta, em que, numa fase da vida em que ela já tem filhos e ela ainda tem seus pais vivos, eu chamo de uma fase sanduíche da vida, em que esses papéis todos se misturam.
This idea popped up 4 years ago. It came from a personal need to tell the story of these contemporary women who have kids and still have their parents alive and who are in, like the filling of a sandwich, and who try to juggle with many roles and find it very hard to cope. Mm-hmm.
So do you yourself see yourself in the main character of Rosa?
Sim, me vejo. Me vejo, vejo minhas amigas. Vejo retratado ali a minha vizinha. Muitas mulheres próximas ou não tão próximas de entrevista de uma revista ou de uma matéria na internet, elas são todas Rosa.
Yes, I see myself in the film, and I see neighbors, friends, women that are not so close. They're all portrayed in the film. I see women whose testimony I read in a newspaper. I see friends, neighbors. We're all Rosa.
I find it very interesting that you say that, because Rosa's character feels very close to me, and I'm from Eastern Europe. Now I live in Berlin, and it seems like it's very current and contemporary here. I was wondering if it's the same for women in South America as well.
A minha surpresa é perceber que nós lá em South America somos a mesma aqui na Europa, em Berlim e na Polônia. Essa é a minha surpresa. Eu achava que nós éramos mulheres mais atrasadas, que não tínhamos parado para questionar isso. E a minha surpresa é que, não, isso é um pensamento global. Veja a marcha das mulheres, né? Nos Estados Unidos recentemente.
To my great surprise, this reality is not only enshrined to Brazil, but also to Europe. I didn't know that. I thought this was a problem that only affected us, that we were backwards, but actually not. And you can see this in Women's March that took place not long ago and that had a strong impact in all of us.
I think you are used to see South America as an exotic place, and it's normal because with the favelas movies and the violence and the Amazonia, but Rio de Janeiro and São Paulo and the main cities, we are all the same.
Yeah, but I think this is a festival.
But like, the festivals use they used to choose exotic movies about slavery or about poverty with these countries, and I think we're glad to show here at Berlinale a movie, a Brazilian movie, that with a story that can happen everywhere in Argentina, in Berlin, in Paris, in New York. It's a universal story.
Yeah, I think this is an amazing aspect of this film, that it shows you that contemporary people in the foreign land, in the foreign continent, and we actually realize we can identify with you, and we're pretty much all the same, which is not maybe so good, taking the subject of the movie.
Yeah, I think so.
But what about you, Maria? How did you find yourself in that part? Is it close to you as well?
Yes, I'm completely Rosa. When I read the script, when Laís invited me, I am a big fan of Laís. She made a lot of very important films in Brazil, and she's a woman, and she writes too. She wrote the script, and when I saw, I said, "Okay, you stole my life. You read my letters. You read my diary." But no, we are all the same. I have two sons instead of two daughters, but I have problems with my mother. I think it's a difficult relationship, and I want to work. I want to have pleasure. I want to be safe. I want to be free. That's impossible.
Yeah.
We want everything.
We want to have.
We want the same rights. We want our partner to wash the dishes, but we still want someone to carry on our luggage sometimes. So we are in the middle of a huge process, I think. We don't know how it's going to end, but we're trying. This is already something.
Mm-hmm. Well, the film has a very feminist sound to it, and it's centered around your character. But if I understand correctly, you wrote the screenplay together with your husband?
This is a tricky question.
Yes.
But I understand it was your idea initially.
Luiz Bolognese é um escritor, roteirista e diretor também de cinema. Os meus filmes anteriores, o roteiro dele, com um argumento meu e discutindo com ele, sempre muito próxima. Mas nesse filme foi a primeira vez que eu falei, eu quero escrever. Ele participou na escrita no primeiro tratamento e depois, nos outros tratamentos, eu escrevi, sempre trocando, sim, com ele. É um parceiro meu de visão de mundo. É meu marido, mas recentemente meu ex-marido, mas meu grande amigo.
Luis Bolognese is a great director and also a screenwriter, and I've been working with him for years and years and working on scripts together. But this was the first time where I said, I want to write the script. And he only helped me in the first version of the script, and all the rest I did. So Luis Bolognese was my husband, is my ex-husband, but still a very, very good friend.
I understand. It's just interesting to, it's a very intimate film, and especially if you say you identify with the character, it's interesting to know you had this male input in creating it. Because men in the movie, I'm not sure if I'm...
You're right. Yes. You're right. You're sure.
I'm looking for a girlfriend.
Yes, they are they are portrayed as a little weak, I think.
Como fracos, sendo fracos. Os homens são retratados como seres fracos. Não, são muitas as leituras. Mais uma vez, citando a psicanalista brasileira Maria Rita Kell, o que ela explica hoje da relação entre homem e mulher, dando um exemplo, é como um cobertor curto que você tem que dividir. Então, a mulher agora pegou, estava com frio, e pegou esse cobertor e falou, ai, que bom, finalmente agora está agradável, eu estou quentinha e me sinto com liberdade. Só que o mesmo cobertor sai do homem e ele fala pela primeira vez, o que acontece? Eu estou com frio. E o que fazer com isso? Porque é o único cobertor. Nós temos que achar uma nova forma de equilíbrio nas relações.
So, you can interpret it in various ways. And I'd like to answer your question quoting a Brazilian psychoanalyst called Maria Rita Kell, who came up with this metaphor of a tituve that is shared between a woman and a man. And for the first time, the woman has the courage to grab the duvet and say, oh, it's feeling warm, it's feeling great. And for the first time, the man feels cold and says, wow, what is this? So what we have to do is find a different way of sharing things, of arranging ourselves around this duvet.
I think we are all messed up. I think we can't say the men are evil, they're guilty. They are raised with mothers that I usually tell a story that I have a grandson, because I have two sons, a 14-year-old boy and a 7-year-old boy. And my 7-year-old boy, he has a son, a doll, a boy, and he takes care of Caetano, my grandson. Maybe he's going to be different, but we are, it's not our fault. It's not their fault. It's not our fault. We're trying to do something different. They are confused. I think it's okay. No, we can't blame them, men, you know.
Of course.
But sometimes we can leave them.
Talvez assim, um questionamento meu pessoal que levei para o filme e que não é, mais uma vez, não é meu, mas eu de conhecidos e das revistas, é esse formato atual que nós herdamos, milenar, né, de estrutura familiar, não funciona mais para a nossa sociedade contemporânea. Ela está defasada. Nós precisamos redescobrir novos formatos familiares. Qual é? Eu não sei. É muito, muito complexo. Mas uma coisa eu sei. Precisa ser combinado o jogo e precisa essa honestidade. Tem que ser igual. A regra do jogo tem que ser igual para todo mundo.
There's something I've been questioning, and I'm not the only one. I could realize this talking to other people and reading. It's the whole format of the family model. This old format that goes back thousands of years, it's not working anymore. We need to find a new format. I don't know how, but this one is out of date. And a new format has to be negotiated. It has to be on an equal level, an equal playing field.
I totally agree, and actually I really liked how your movie daughters loved the story of Eve as their bedtime story. And you, your character resisted telling this story for a while.
Yes.
And the story actually captures this very patriarchal society with a man ruling over a woman who's in pain, but who's kind of in his power all the time.
When I read that, yeah.
I said, it's not true. I never read the Bible. And Laish said, no, it's the Bible. It's the Bible. It's amazing. It's in our skin, and we don't realize sometimes. It's very ancestral, né?
Primitive.
But why do you think Rosa didn't want to tell this story to her daughters at first? And then she's changed her mind and actually told it again.
I think that the story that Rosa used to tell her daughters is not the story that he read at the hotel when she was alone looking for her new father. I think the story of Eva, and it's funny because she that's your name. That's
your name.
Yeah, she's Eva. I think it was a different story. I think it was a story, a children's story, not the one that I read. Você entendeu que ela perguntou se
porque eu resistia a contar.
Mas eu acho que a história que ela contava
não era assim.
Não era assim.
Porque why did she resist telling it? But I think the story she used to tell was not like this.
É um pouco mais, a história da Eva que nós contamos é sempre um pouco mais romântica, da cobra, da maçã, mas nunca que Deus deu a dor para essa mulher como castigo e punição. Essa é a história que está na Bíblia, mas quando a gente fica nessa coisa oral, a gente romantiza um pouco e a gente não percebe que existe já na palavra de Deus essa visão machista embutida, que está aí, isso foi escrita há sei lá quantos, né?
In Brazil, we have a Bible in every hotel.
Same in Europe.
Just let me tell you, when we tell Eve's story, we always romanticize and we talk about the apple and the snake and we sort of change it. But it is in the Bible that she was punished. She was punished for what she did. So there was already a machistic narrative embedded in the Bible.
Yeah, that was very interesting. I remember listening to the story as it was being told over the phone. And my reaction was similar to your film cousin's reaction.
Sister.
Yes. I was like, what kind of book is this?
What kind of book is this? My reaction too, and I'm 41. I didn't. It's amazing.
Yeah. But speaking of books, you also reference another book, another play in the movie, Ibsen's The Doll's House. And I have a question about this because Rosa is writing her own play that's based on, well, she gets inspired originally by The Doll's House. And in the end...
She's reading Doll's House and the second Simone de Beauvoir.
Yes, exactly. So there's this big feminist feel to it. But towards the end, when you're trying to actually, that you finish the play and you're trying to get it produced and directed, you explain it in a way as if the beginning of your play is the ending of Ibsen's play. So Nora leaves her family behind, she leaves her children behind, and she starts her own life solo, exploring herself, finding out who she really is without being tied to all these things. And I wonder how the film really goes after it finishes, because you confess to your husband you've had an affair.
Yes.
Not only an affair, that you fell in love with another man.
Which is worst.
Yes. He seems to be, we don't know if he's lying or not, but it kind of seems that way, that his conscience might not be very clean, but he's not confessing to anything. And I wonder...
Yeah, we never know if he cheated her or not.
But my question is, are you like Nora? Because it doesn't feel like you're going to leave the family behind. It feels like you're going to try to find yourself within the family.
I think Laish should ask, because it's her script.
Se a própria Rosa é a Nora...
Se a Rosa deixaria a família, né?
Ah,
que se a peça começa a partir do fim da casa de bonecas, como seria essa... Porque na casa de bonecas ela deixa os filhos para trás,
embora.
Né?
É muito forte isso, né?
I wouldn't, Maria.
Não, no filme realmente isso não fica claro.
se ela deixa essa família, né, para trás ou não. Mas, ao mesmo tempo, diferente da Nora, na peça, ela sai e ela larga todo mundo. Né? Eu acho que a Rosa, ela larga a estrutura familiar, mas não todo mundo. Ela continua com suas filhas, ela continua com a sua vida, mas o que ela larga tudo para trás, mas esse formato antiquado de estrutura familiar que ela não aguenta mais. É quase um largar simbólico.
And at the end, sorry.
In Ibsen's play, Nora leaves everything behind, and in my film it's not very clear if she leaves everybody behind. I don't think she abandons the family, but what she does is she drops this old-fashioned family structure in the pursuit for a new one, a new format.
In the end, and in the movie, at the end, Rosa, she's all the time with, we don't know if she is with Dado, if she is with Pedro, if she is alone, but she is with the girls, riding bicycle and...
And smiling,
and with the girls, the three together.
Last question. The movie, clearly initially is about your character is in the center of it, and it's about your relationship with yourself, really. But there's also a very strong mother character present and conflict between mother, daughter. And I don't think, was this mother-daughter relationship something you were thinking of exposing when you were writing the script, or is it,
yes,
yeah?
Yes,
eu acho que é tema pouco explorado ainda, tanto na literatura como no cinema, porque nós mulheres não nos demos conta do quanto essa relação é complexa. Nós costumamos falar mais da relação da filha com o seu pai, a imagem do pai. Mas nunca... E essa mãe? E essa mãe, não só a relação entre mulheres, mas a relação entre mulheres de diferentes gerações. Uma filha entrando na adolescência, por exemplo, no caso da Rosa, e ela caminhando para o envelhecer. Uma mãe indo para a morte, né? Então são três gerações de mulheres, cada uma numa situação, e existe atrito nisso. Não é simples envelhecer.
I chose this theme deliberately. We always talk about the relationship between a daughter and a father, but we never really explore, be it in film, be it in literature, the theme of the relationship between the mother and the daughter. And I wanted to bring this in, because we are not fully aware as women that this is an issue, that this is a real problem. And so I have Rosa with a pre-adolescent daughter at this, who is reaching an age. She, Rosa, is aging, and at the same time she's relating to a mother who is heading towards death. So it was deliberate. We have to talk about these issues.
E existe pouca literatura sobre esse tema. Tem outro psicanalista, ele é italiano, mas mora no Brasil, que eu adoro, que é o Contardo Caligaris. E eu li um texto dele, que ele faz essa comparação dos contos de fadas, em que ali já diz o conflito das duas gerações. Então, uma madrasta que quer matar aquela menina, no caso a Branca de Neve, porque ela se olha no espelho e não se reconhece mais, se vê velha. E quem é a mais bonita é aquela menina jovem. Eu não aguento isso. Eu quero matá-la.
It's not even properly explored in literature. And there's another psychoanalyst who I love. He's Italian, but he lives in Brazil, Contardo Caligaris. And he uses fairy tales to mention this poor relationship between mother and daughter. Mm-hmm. And he uses fairy tales, for instance, Snow White, where you have the mean stepmother, Snow White, and she can't stand it. She can't stand see that she is aging. She looks at herself at the mirror and she just can't stand it. She wants to kill the other girl who's blossoming.
Mm-hmm. Like in that book you were given.
Como no livro que te deram. É uma fotógrafa norte-americana maravilhosa.
It's a wonderful North American photographer.
Gina Goldenstein.
She's the author of those photographs.
I, I wish we could talk more, but clearly we're not allowed. But it was a pleasure to meet you and to talk to you. And I really loved the movie, not only because I had to watch it, I really, really liked it. So good luck with it and the festival.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.